The leaves of this plant have cells that carry out photosynthesis. If we zoom in on this photosynthetic plant cell, we can see the chloroplast, where the reactions of photosynthesis occur. Photosynthesis consists of two primary steps, the light reactions and the Kelvin cycle reactions. In this tutorial, we'll focus exclusively on the Kelvin cycle reactions. The overall purpose of the Kelvin cycle is to convert carbon dioxide from the atmosphere into carbohydrates, or sugars, which the plant needs to power its cellular activities and build new plant structures. The Kelvin cycle reactions occur within the stroma of the chloroplast. The reactions use the ATP and NADPH produced by the light reactions to convert the CO2 to carbohydrate. Let's zoom into the Kelvin cycle to take a closer look. The Kelvin cycle could be divided into three phases: carbon dioxide fixation, carbon dioxide reduction, and regeneration of RUBP. The first phase, carbon dioxide fixation, basically captures the CO2 from the atmosphere so it can be used in the reactions. To do this, CO2 is attached to RUBP, a 5-carbon molecule. The enzyme used in this reaction is called Rubisco, and the result of the reaction is an unstable 6-carbon molecule that quickly splits into 2 3-carbon molecules called 3-phosphoglycerate, or 3PG. Next, the process of converting the CO2 to carbohydrate begins. This phase is called the carbon dioxide reduction phase because we're adding electrons and energy to the CO2 molecule. During this phase, a sequence of reactions uses NADPH and some of the ATP from the light reactions. These molecules supply the needed electrons and energy for CO2 reduction. Electrons are added from NADPH, and through a series of reactions, 3PG is reduced to form G3P, a carbohydrate. ADP and NADP+ return to the thylakoids to be converted back to ATP and NADPH by the light reactions. One of the G3P molecules is set aside to be used as a building block for glucose, but the majority of the G3P molecules move forward into the third phase of the Kelvin cycle. In this phase, ATP is used to combine the rest of the G3P molecules to form RUBP molecules. This RUBP can then combine with additional carbon dioxide molecules, continuing the carbon reactions. To form a glucose molecule, the cycle actually has to turn 6 times, because each turn of the cycle adds only 1 carbon atom from the incoming carbon dioxide. It's important to remember that the Kelvin cycle is dependent on the light reactions to provide NADPH and ATP, which in turn provide the electrons and energy needed to form carbohydrates,